Friends, Tinkercad no longer supports auto group when you export. I can show you why, so let's get cracking. This is Tinkercad.com. Of course, when you visit, you can simply choose sign in with Google. All your designs are saved to the cloud, and it is totally free, and it runs in your web browser. Now, today, I'm going to talk to you about updates. If you want to stay completely updated, don't forget, hit that subscribe button, and also turn notifications on. And then in Tinkercad, I want to highlight the Tinkercad blog. We can simply click resources, and then right here is the Tinkercad blog. This is where the bundle groups were explained. Of course, I've got a tutorial. I'll have that listed in the corner as well. Of course, you can do by all, or you can switch to tips and tricks. Tons of great information in here, but of course, you can also choose to get your information from me. Today, we're going to start by simply hitting create new 3D design. Now, the first thing I always want to highlight is naming a file. That way you can find them later. This one's just going to be called Quick Tips. And then in Tinkercad, we always design with solids. If you bring a piece out, you can adjust it. If you bring another piece out that is a hole, you can push it in, or you can use the control up arrows. You can adjust that. And then for a while, people were using an undocumented feature. This was not intended to work by Tinkercad, but it did. If you grabbed those two, with this one being a hole, and you clicked export, when Tinkercad exported it, it auto-grouped that and made it a hole. Now, the correct way to do this was to grab the two. I'm going to align them real quick. I'm going to just hit L for align and choose center and center, pretending I wanted that like that. And then do control G to group. This is a union group, so now that is cut out, and when we export that piece, it would print with the cylinder and a little cube cut out. That's how Tinkercad was supposed to work. Somebody had just found the other trick and shared it with the world. So Tinkercad just introduced a new kind of grouping called bundle groups. I'm gonna bring out this heart real quick. I'm gonna make it thin, and I'm gonna show you one of my favorite skills. We're just going to click on that and do control D. I'm going to nudge it with the arrows. I just did a shift right. I'm going to rotate it so I'm not clicking anywhere else. And I'm also going to twist it a couple degrees just for giggles. And then when I let go, I'm going to do control D again and again. And I'm just making a cool pattern flower that goes up and up and up and up. So it's kind of like a pattern spiral staircase. Do I need this? Absolutely not. Did I think it was fun for what I'm showing you? Yeah. So if I grab all these and do D to drop, they're now at the work plane, and you can see there's 35 shapes, which eventually could get complicated. And I want them to stay together, but I'm not cutting anything out of them. So this time I would use what's called a bundle group. If we click right here, notice it is an instant grouping and it turns green. I'm going to do control D and set that over here, and I'm going to ungroup it. You can also do control shift G to ungroup. That has always been the command. And then this is not super complex, but watch how much longer it takes if I use the standard control G to union group. You see it turning red. That is Tinkercad thinking. I did not change the time, but it went from an instant group to a longer group that we have all glued together. But there's really no reason to have grouped these together. We were not cutting anything out. So what we're trying to teach you here is that if you want to cut something out, you use the control G union group, which we've always had. If you just want parts to stay together, that is when you use the control B to bundle them. When you click on your different designs, you'll always be able to tell whether they are a union group or a bundle group by the little label up top. If you want to convert it to the union group, you can simply click on it and bang, it does. But as you can see, you've still got the red lines where Tinkercad was thinking for a second. Of course, you can also click that and boom, you can see how quickly the bundle group works. Now, I do also want to highlight this. If we search for a complex shape, I am going to use the one called the hyperboloid. Notice it takes a moment to load. When you bring it in, it's pretty fun and fancy. If you ever adjust these handles, it breaks these numbers. So I'm gonna move over here and I'm gonna adjust it. And I'm just gonna tweak these. And you can see just touching this design makes Tinkercad think. It is a complex design. I will also let you know that these shapes were created by people instead of by Tinkercad. So they're not always efficient. If you ever see one of these that says node fails to load, It could be just that it's too complex for Tinkercad. So now I'm going to take this and I'm going to make it fancy by doing Control D. I'm going to do a silly Control Up. I'm going to rotate it a few degrees and I'm going to make it look like some sort of wreath. Once again, let go and do Control D until it goes all the way around. Once again, just showing you that you can make complex designs pretty darn quickly. I can now easily grab these two and do Control H to hide. And I just want to show you whatever this thing is. I'm going to grab it, do D to drop. And if we hit Control Bundle, boom, it was instant. It is grouped. I can now move them together. This is why bundle groups are so slick. If I do Control D and I switch that to a union group, check out how long it takes to compute the shape. And this is where if you have no need to group them, you should always use the bundle group. If you have to cut something out, of course, then you have to do it. But you have to understand you're going to have to be patient as the design is created. There you can see it finally grouped. One last quick tip as you're building. If you want to build smart, do not sleep on the awesome lock tool. This locks pieces in place, which is super handy, and it also does not allow them to group. Notice these, when they're bundled, you can still move them super efficiently. I'm going to hit Control Z quick to put that back the way it was. And if you want full details on the lock tool, I've got a video I'll put up here in the cards. Friends, as I wrap up, if you got a moment, share this everywhere you use Tinkercad. I've seen so many users that are stuck on why their parts aren't grouping. I've always had my tutorials where I tell you to hit Control G. I only learned about the auto export in February, and now that we've got the sweet bundles and of course the typical union groups, it is just no longer needed and it does not work. I do want to quickly say thank you to everybody that's supporting me via YouTube memberships. There are three different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month, and with any amount of support, you get early access to videos. I also want to say thank you to everybody that is supporting me via Patreon. You really need to check out the awesome membership area. It is growing. We are past 200 members. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.